In this tutorial, we'll show you how to use Camtasia animations to zoom and pan your video. First, let's start with a little explanation. Zooming is when you change the scale of a video to make it appear closer or further away. Panning is when you move the video to focus on something new. Zooming and panning are often used together, where you zoom in to focus the viewer's attention, then pan to something important. Let's start with zooming. First, navigate to a point in the video you want to zoom. Then, select Animations in the Tools panel and switch to the Animations tab. Next, click and drag the Scale Up animation to the clip you want to zoom. This adds an animation to the clip with a default zoom already applied. To preview the animation, click and drag the playhead. Notice as the playhead moves over the animation arrow, the clip zooms in. To change when the zoom occurs, click and drag the animation arrow. And to adjust the length of the animation, click and drag either end of the arrow. Now let's adjust the zoom. Make sure the clip is selected and the playhead is after the animation arrow. Then, drag the scale slider in the properties panel to adjust the zoom and reposition the screen recording on the canvas to focus on what's important. Let's give it a look. Nice. Now that the clip is zoomed, let's add a pan animation to show something new. To pan a clip, drag the custom animation to where you want to pan. Then, reposition the screen recording on the canvas. The clip smoothly animates from one location to the next. With our pan finished, let's add a final animation to zoom back out and return the clip to its original state. To do this, drag another custom animation to the timeline or press Shift-A. Then, navigate to the Properties panel and click the Reset button next to Position and Scale to return them to their original settings. We now have a project with three animations. The first zooms in to focus the viewer's attention. The second pans to something new, and the last one zooms back out to show the recording in full. Before we wrap up, here's one really important tip. As you work with zooms and pans in your project, the position of the playhead is critical to success. To change how a clip looks at the end of a zoom or pan, the playhead must be positioned after the animation arrow. And to change how a clip looks at the beginning of a zoom or pan, the playhead must be positioned before the animation arrow. If the playhead is in the middle of an animation arrow, always move it to one of the ends before you work with a clip. Well, that's all for now. Be sure to check out our other tutorials, and as always, thanks for watching.